Last time on Fur Fighters. Oh my god! Oh crap. Rico? What the? Hey! Have some bloody nerve, you ass! Jesus Christ! That's your wife! You sly bastard! Hello everyone, welcome back to the Fur Fighters playthrough from the CC Network, and Rico says hi too. I'm Fred, your ever-reliable host as always, and last time, across that bridge, somewhere behind that water wheel, we went to Beaver Dam, we saved Rico's wife Juanita, and we finished off another world in this game. Today, as you can see by the sign we're in front of, we're going to head straight into Cape Canado, the space station of this world, and where the real test of this game begins. I know I've said that a few times, but this is the level. This is the hub world where everything gets jacked up a bit, because everything we do is going to be a little more challenging. And this duck right here, yeah, he's not like those dreary, big, pelican ducks we saw in New Quack City who are mortally depressed. Oh no, these guys are slightly dozy-eyed but very intelligent ducks who are going to help us along the way. Here's the degree of astrophysics we have to give over, showing that we indeed can go into a space station. And ladies and gentlemen, we enter with our blessings. Of course we do, we're fur fighters. And in we go. I love this level so much. It's ridiculous, really, how much I do. And Cape Canado is probably my favourite out of all the hub worlds here, because space in video games, you can't beat it, can you? And as you can see, look at that! A new loading screen, but no cutscene. There was actually meant to be a cutscene here to detail it, because it happens for every level. But there wasn't, due to the fact there was no disk space on the original Dreamcast version to have it. Now, as you can see, the brown bear is wearing a space suit. Not going to protect him here. It isn't going to protect him. I love it. These guys think, oh, we're wearing spacesuits now. We're therefore protected from potential death. Well, I say potential death. I think inevitable death. But hey, they've got something going for them. And I don't have to really do much. Now, before we get into the first level of this game, I have to do some exploring, because there's a few little things we need to deal with. The first off is in the corner here. This, ladies and gentlemen, was foreshadowed to us in the gun shop in World Lois Quack. Sorry, I almost got the place wrong. There, ladies and gentlemen, is the best weapon in the game, bar none. Auto shotgun. This weapon fires out shotgun pellets really consistently. I'll show you this, right? Here's the action. Okay, I'm going to show you this for a second, so if you notice the difference. Here is the shotgun. One gone. I had to wait for a bit, shoot another, right? That's pretty bog standard. Pretty poor, actually, if you would dare say so. The fact is, though, I can make that a lot better when I upgrade to the auto shotgun. Now, why am I going in here? It's the planetarium. And the music here is fantastic. See that? One shot. Two shots, immediately fired. That's what the auto shotgun can do. The reason why I'm here? To shoot that peacock, for a start. And that didn't do anything. See, that's the problem with the seeker launcher. It doesn't actually aim on high up enemies. And I'm sorry, if you can hear the music in the background, it's my favorite thing in this entire game. Apart from the Undermill, of course. So there's the seeker launcher. We already have that. But this is the weapon I'm here for. Ladies and gentlemen, the much maligned but incredibly powerful neutron gun. This thing sends out a blast, which if any enemy is in its range, will immediately die upon its explosion. There's one small problem, though. That 4 smart ammo you see right there is the only ammo it has. You cannot find smart ammo anywhere in this game. It's one of the actual things I love, is that you have to use this ammo wisely. But the good thing is, I've never needed it. The gun's just been there in case we've had to, because the auto shotgun is the weapon we're going to use. And we are about to venture off. In fact, I will show you the auto shotgun's potency against this bear. One shot, two shots, dead. See? Even better than before. One shot, dead. These guys cannot survive. The auto shotgun's upped power. And it's brilliant. It is utterly superb. Utterly fantastic. And I love it. Now, we're going to start here. In the VAB building. This is our first level. And in comes the nightmares. Because, ladies and gentlemen, we've entered a space station. But we have to start all the way from the bottom in this sector. This level is one that makes my head spin. And it's known to, because there is a lot you have to do to make this all go right. We have to try in the process of getting this space shuttle ready for launch. That's what we have to do. In fact, look at this. This just shows us exactly what we have to do. We have to get the space shuttle off of its launching plane, load it with all its cargo, put its fuel tank on, and then load it up onto the mover to take it to the launch site. The second level, the VLF facility, I keep getting this wrong, will inevitably cause us to get that shuttle ready to launch. And then the last place, well, that's going to be a surprise. I'm going to leave that one for all of you to find out in 2 episodes' time. And look at the power this gun has. It's ridiculous. It's insane. It's ridiculous. I love this shotgun. The shotgun was already a little overpowered. This is now the best weapon in the entire game, and it's great. We've entered a new level, and no one can stop us. You'd think. I wouldn't think that they would. But anyway, let's look at this level from a simple point of view. 5 babies to collect, that's not that many. But what this level is about is us doing the act of getting a space shuttle ready for launch. That's what we're doing. And as you can see, gold tokens all around. There are 100 tokens in this level. Getting them, however, is going to be a problem because this level is complex, it is long, it is ridiculous, and there's a lot of things that could go wrong in the process. One of them being that space shuttle. There, you see it up there. We need to get that plane down. And, well, that's our job now with this guy. Hello, Mr. Duck. Yes, and we are actually called a doctor because we have a degree in astrophysics that counts for all the characters. I find that weird. Nonetheless, there is a small child in charge of that plane, and we have to land it. As you can see, there is little Tweak Baby, very, very happy with himself, that he actually outdid the bungalow babies in operating heavy machinery. Now, here is one of the toughest things this game will throw at you. A mini game where you have to try and land a plane. This is utterly insane. I've done this as the lone person who's done it for years in my family. I have done, oh god, danger escalating quickly, come on, thrust back up, damn it. Gotta keep doing this. If I get this, oh god, no. If I can get this done on my first try, yeah. Come on. If I get this done on my first try, I have never done this on my first, you gotta be kidding me. Oh my god! Holy crap! I thought it would take multiple tries to land that thing and you'd be seeing me raging. This is awesome! This is ridiculous! Oh my god! I am so happy because now I get to shave time off this video that would have been spent doing that over and over again. This is... Oh my god, you have no idea how good I feel right now. This is ridiculous. And look here. Look at that. The shuttle being taken off the plane. I'm in euphoria. And just everything is coming up Freddy right now. This is awesome. I love it. I cannot believe this has just happened. And it's amazing. Oh, Jesus wept. Because every time that rocket gets destroyed, ladies and gentlemen, we have to watch this guy right here tell me that it costs, what, a couple million? Possibly more than that. And it's just, it gets a bit sad because every time it goes, well, at least we can try again, right? And there's a sight of the plane and the rocket just destroyed and, It's ridiculous. I cannot believe I've just done that. The amount of times I've failed that. I've done it in the end, but I've never done it first try. before. That is... I said a few episodes back, I'm bringing out my best, my A game for this playthrough, and I wasn't bloody lying now that's happened. Jesus. Right, Fred, you've got to save your energy. This level's going to be a long one, and you've got to make sure you don't run out too fast. Because there's an enemy out here that'll outrun all of us. And there it is. Ah! Fucking God. The other one. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a fox. They have two pistols. They are bastards, and they are so annoying. They will run around, they will continuously annoy you, and there's bears everywhere now, and it's just... These enemies will kick your ass if you let them swamp you. That's the problem with this now. We've got another enemy in tow. They're going to keep shooting at us. And look at that. They're so cute as well. But at the end of the day, that's not who we need to worry ourselves about. The foxes will cause problems, but thankfully, they're not around a lot in this game. They're only in specific little places where we have enough room to maneuver. It makes things a lot easier. Right, now, as you may have noticed, why am I walking across here? Well, as you notice, we're bungalow. There is no way in hell we're going to get onto that plane to get the baby that's inside it. So, of course, at the top of one of these silos, who else do you think is actually going to be there? It's going to be Tweak, and we need to use little Dragonette's power to fly, glide... glide, probably, because he can't gain altitude to get onto that plane. So how do we get altitude? We climb on top of these, and holy mother of Jesus God, I nearly fell off there. Come on, Tweak. It's your time to shine. I do want to point something else out. Just going to stand here for a sec. The music changes every time the character changes in the teleport. I don't know if you guys noticed that. And to have the... whistles and synthesizers for Tweaks instead of the didgeridoos for bungalows is quite nice. I've always loved that about this game, having a diverse soundtrack. I may have mentioned it already. I don't know if I have. If I haven't, well, this is the first time I've mentioned it, and you guys may not have had keen ears. Nonetheless, we are now in the plane, and here comes the Tweak baby. What letter will it have this time? Is it going to be an A? Is it going to be a Z? Well, we're going to find out now. An H, or an H, if you're British. Seriously, the glottal stop is there for anyone who's ever been born around the estuary and anywhere around London, Essex, Suffolk area. The estuary slang version will be there. But nonetheless, the Tweak baby has somehow gotten out of this plane in its jetpack, I don't know how, and we're now ready to enter the next part of our adventure. Now, of course, we've learned from previous times, do not let Tweak fall, because he will suffer damage. Look how tall this thing is! Ladies and gentlemen, the size of the people living in this world compared to the stuff that's in it is insane. We now have to go here. And General Bristol, he will reaffirm all I've already mentioned, right? It has to be loaded into the VAB building, it must then be loaded with pods, and all that stuff, and then finally receive its mission instructions to be moved ready to the launch site. That's all we have to do here. We not only have to save the babies, but we have to ensure that rocket is ready. Now, what are we going to do to enable that? There is doors aplenty around here. We have to now go through each of them and figure out what the hell we have to do and do it in order. It's pretty mad, and I've said this before to myself. This is the level where everything goes tits up if you get something wrong. Because you could forget to do something and everything will just not work. If you completely bypass a section of this game, and this level, and decide to quit, you're going to forget about it and you're not going to come back here and not remember what to do. And oh, good God almighty. Oh, God. Tweak. Oh, Jesus. I managed to get into bungalow there. Come on, you bastard. Ah, or a shotgun. Oh, Jesus Christ. That's why you don't mess with polar bears. This is why I'm rubbish at strafing. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to see how rubbish I am when playing my favorite game of all time, this is how I show it. Jesus Christ. Oh, my bloody hell. This, ladies and gentlemen, is what I mean. This level has bears out the arse. It has enemies everywhere. They want to mess with you. And you can hear, upstairs, a Chang baby. Shot each other. I love it. This is going to get quite hectic because Cape Canado will try to mess with you. And once again, we have to change character because that Chang baby is up there. I can hear armadillos, but I don't know where they are. God, that's scaring me. Nonetheless, up we go. Someone pointed this out to me the other day. I say nonetheless in this video too much, but I can't think of another word than anyway or moving on. You know, it's a problem. Nonetheless, God, I said it again, didn't I? We have got 28 tokens. There's another baby. And lo and behold, we're going to get that baby. Chang, another one of your children is safe. It's Amy, again one of my favourite names in all the world, as we send her out where I don't know. I don't know how she's going to find her way out before the bears shoot her down. Because they can do that, I presume. Nonetheless, I keep saying nonetheless. Stop it, Fred, you're now making attention to it. We have to go in here. Why am I going in here, you may be asking? Because of another weapon. Hey! Bears! Don't surprise me like that. Jesus Christ, you could have done something a lot better than... I mean, unless you were going to throw me a surprise party or something, I would have been happy for you to do that. But alas, it was not to be. But as you can see, on that little pedestal there is another weapon. We've discovered three weapons in this entire video alone. And this is that third one. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce you to the freeze gun. By definition, this will freeze whatever the hell is hit by it. And we have a new ammo type to look out for. The hell? I didn't even press the side button there. That was weird. Nonetheless, anyway, moving on. Whatever one you want me to say, it's time for us to move on. Because that is now Chang's mission here done. We don't need to use him for a little while. That's perfectly fine. We're going to make sure we get down from here without hurting ourselves. We're already decently low on health. And once again, I can hear those armadillos squirming away. I wonder where they are. I wonder what they're doing. I'm going around the pod here just to check for any tokens because you never know. There could be. And there is not. I had a feeling there wasn't going to be any, and I was just doing that to cover my bases. Now, the freeze gun. The important thing you must know about it is you cannot freeze polar bears with it. Logically, you can't. Because that, of course, means they wouldn't like ice. They live in icy conditions. And Bungalow has healed a little bit. We can advance forward into this authorized ducks only. Hey, we have a bloody degree in astrophysics. We can do whatever we want. And here is a wind tunnel, if you couldn't tell. There'll be giant fans in the way, stopping us from reaching this end goal here. And right at the end there is another bungalow baby. Because, yes, we would. This aerodynamics factory here blasts us down. Now, there are some gold tokens here. We need to get out of here before the wind tunnel gets back on. Because if it does, it'll take us and blast us to another dimension. Now, we don't need to go through there yet. There is a bear over there, and I'm going to save myself time by launching a rocket at it. It doesn't work because the wind tunnel's blasting. But as you can see, the wind tunnel has a very short blast. That didn't work either. Oh, God! The wind tunnel was blasting me around, and there is the seeker launcher doing exactly what I want it to do. Now, there's no tokens down there. There's... Hold on. Do we send our babies on jetpacks that are tested in wind tunnels at a space station? I mean, the fur fighters have connections, but I didn't think they'd have that many. Yeah, Bungo, look at me. God damn, that's kind of scary, I'm not going to lie, how much influence and power these guys have. Jesus Christ. Anyway, we're going to move on. As you can see, that's how much of a difference. These wind tunnels are now getting more powerful, but also lasting for a shorter period of time each time. We've got to be careful! Oh God, please don't kill us! Oh fuck. This, if you are uninitiated and you have no control over your character, that's going to cause you a lot of issues. And, oh Jesus Christ, this, I said before that Beaver Dam was out to kill us. I was wrong. This is out to kill us. And hello, Bungalow Baby. Hello, Joey. We have a Joey called Joey. How brilliant is that? It's mesmerizing. It's spectacular. We've done that. We've gotten the baby. We're safe for now. Because I said, ladies and gentlemen, there's no other way out of here outside of that lift. We now have to go there and go up further into this building without being potentially killed by a wind tunnel. Oh, thank God. Thank God that doesn't last very long because we can just jump across and everything will be fine. Everything in this zone, everything in this level, everything in this world in Cape Canaveral is trying to kill us. Because environmental deaths are fun. You've already seen a few of those in Beaver Dam before. This is now where I start getting scared. Because I know how dangerous this level can be. We're in the voyages of trying to get into space. So of course we're going to suffer immense problems. Hello, bears. Okay, I'm not going to deal with you anymore. Thank God I didn't hit the button there. That would have caused even more problems. And as you can see, we're running out of, running low of, I should say, ammo. And there is the armadillos. There are the armadillos I spoke of before. And one of them killed the other one. And of course, I did mention last time in Beaver Dam a few episodes ago that the armadillos are difficult to kill. They are. But you just got to remember, like most enemies, positioning is key. It's imperative you remember where things are, where you can shoot at them, you can strafe, jump. Everything works to your favor at some point here. I haven't beheaded anyone here yet, so we need to do something about it. And as you can tell, well, I heard a peek. Oh, God. I hate these guys. There we go. Even the most powerful shotgun. See, you couldn't have done that with the other shotgun, could you? It's brilliant. Now, what does this monitor tell me? Yeah. We're not allowed to prep the satellite yet. So, we can't load the satellite because it hasn't been prepped. So, it's our job to do just that. Come on, you bastard. Hello, polar bear. Okay, I can shoot the helmet off, but I can't get a headshot both times. That's depressing. As you can see here, we need to load up the satellite. And look at this old guy. Who tells us the RV buggy is almost ready, but it just needs sterilizing. Because if we don't do that, we'll have germs in the in space, and that's bad. It's now up to us to control that buggy. And how are we doing that? Look at this! We've gone from a furry animal shooting game to an RC simulator. And of course, here's the sterilization booth. Let's go in and get this job done. Oh. Really? We're in a damn space station! And you haven't got a working decontamination unit. Okay. Alright, I mean, it's not like we're publicly funding you guys or anything. You're NASA! Or Quaxa? I don't know what the abbreviation is in this world, because it's all duck related, you know, with duck puns are back. Just, I don't know what to say. We now have to go through here. There's no other way out, so of course we go through this system. We go out of here into a tunnel. Now, what does this tunnel do? Well, it could cause problems. If we don't go down here, we will flip over and have to restart again. Also, I love the fact that this RV lunar module has a flag on it. Now, as you can see, we're out in the middle of the jungle. But we're out in the middle of nowhere, and there's a swamp. Do not go in there, because if you do, again, we have to start all over again, and that is not good. I already have a good record in this level thus far. And as you can see, a lot of levels to get hit with, and look at this. Hey, there we go. You can run over birds with this thing, and no one gives a crap. Sorry, Peter. Yeah, I ran over a pheasant the other day. Oh, how did I run it over? Oh, I was controlling an RC car, and, well, you know the rest of the story. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now going up this really nicely placed piece of discontinued and decommissioned rocket engineering as we go in here. Now, where the hell are we? You may be questioning yourselves as I almost tipped this thing. We are in the recreational area for the astronauts. Look at that! We can play with a ball! Oh, this game is just... It's brimming with content. It's brimming with content, ladies and gentlemen. As we enter this bathroom, shower room, which of course is for males only because, you know, NASA ain't all that fair. And we need to decontaminate because there's no decontamination units that's out of order. So what do? Push a bar of soap into a swimming pool. And look at that. You saw the color change? Look at the bubbles around that soap. That's attention to detail in a game if I ever saw one. And we are now clean. But that journey for us is not over yet. We had to get out of here. We had to go back to the site with the satellite. And to do that, ladies and gentlemen, is a fraught process. Because we have to get off here without potentially turning our rover over. And yes, that wasn't a rhyme, that's just stuff that sounds the same. Okay, gotten down there. We've got to make sure we don't go into the swampy water. If we do, we have to go all the way back to our soapy bath and redo all we've just done. And of course, these mounds can flip us over at any time. We're going to take this quite slowly, quite measured. Like anything in a scientific process such as this, we have to try and make sure everything is done according to plan with no errors. Because if you have an error in space missions, you know what happened. Look at Columbia and Challenger for anything that could go wrong. Or I would dare say even Apollo 13, where danger was averted. But you know, of course, how that worked out if your knowledge of space history and films are your notion of expertise. As you can see through my rambling and being able to do multiple things at once, because I'm a man who multitasks, which makes all women shocked at the idea that a man can multitask. Hey, I'm talking to you guys while playing a video game, while trying to think things to say at the same time. I'm using three parts of myself to make this possible. Should I be rewarded a medal? Possibly. Anyway, we've now gotten the lunar rover up. And look at this. Look how clean it looks. It's majestic as we go up this excessively long. Because they were hoping we'd actually not be able to control this and fall off and start again. But oh no, not in this playthrough. And that's a nice clean buggy. Thank you, Mr. Scientist Man. As we drive it in, and the buggy is now ready for deployment. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The thing is, I know I've said that this game is exciting, it's thrilling at times, but all we're doing is just doing these guys' menial work for us. For them, sorry. We are doing the capable hero trope and metric fuck ton of justice here. We are doing what everyone here is employed to do. Or maybe because we have a degree in astrophysics, we're considered equal unto the workforce. I never realized that until now. As the satellite is plopped into the space shuttle, and all is well? All is well. Yeah, okay. Well, there's some bears over there, and that is now done. Okay, that is fine. The thing is now, we have to prep the satellite, and that is not our job. You see, we could jump, but look how high that gets. And as you can see, if you've got your eagle eyes pinned, there are some claw marks. We need Juliet to do this job. And I'm telling you, this is definitely her job. We've already suffered many lost lives through her. And I'm hoping we don't suffer any more. We suffered one in the Quackenheim. We suffered, I think, about three inside the God of Drilling up at God Machine Valley. But as you can see, look how fantastic this music sounds, if you can hear it. Cape Canaveral just wins. I love it to pieces. And as you can tell, look how angular all of this is. If you don't control yourself, you're going to have a bad time, to quote the South Park ski instructor. We are going to have problems. Thank God I know what I'm doing. Says the guy who's died multiple times and shown ineptitude upon not realizing what the hell he's doing. You know through this, I've shown my weakness. But looky here. Look how dangerous this is. Jumping time! Oh my god, you saw me changing directions 3 times there! Did you think I wasn't going to do it? Hell nah! I'm doing exactly what I've come here to do. And as you can see, the platforms may look small, but they're really not. They're about the same width as Juliet's abnormally large melon head. But as you can see, we've now reached the top. How bitchiful. Well, beautiful, I really should say, but for some reason I got that wrong. I, for some reason, don't know why. But here, ladies and gentlemen, the satellite's now folded in. And that's great. We have now done a part of the job. I say part of it because look at what's over there. If you didn't notice, there is another button. And I believe that is the button that will do the job. Do not... Oh, I only suffered 5 bits of health because the wall saved my ass. Here we go. The satellite is now in. Look at that. In goes all the prongs, the radial dishes. And that is fantastic. We've done that. Now, because I don't want to die falling down, here is Tweak. Now, where do we go from here, you may be asking? Well, the only way is down. And, yeah. Down. That's all I need to say, really. Oh, God! See, that's what happens if you jump off without any due care and attention. And now we've got the satellite done. Press this button. The satellite's now going to go. And we are making progress. We're going to get the space shuttle up into space, everybody. I mean, as a person who is 25 years old and who hasn't had any major space developments, I believe, since a few rovers and a few space shuttles that really haven't done that much. And my love of space isn't as big as some people, but I do find it unbelievably fascinating. I'm not smart enough to get a degree in astrophysics or know enough about maths or whatever to do this stuff, but space is oddly fascinating. And as a kid, playing this level, getting all this done and going, oh my god, I'm actually gonna go into space. You never got that in a lot of games I played as a kid, because, okay, Sonic Adventure 2, we went into space only because we stole a spaceship and that's all. This made me feel happy. Upon the point that I completely forgot that, well, it wasn't gonna work like that. Okay, polar bears, shotgun. I'm gonna lose all my shotgun ammo. I need to stop it. Die, you prick. There we go. Now, as you may notice, this spaceship is perfectly fine thus far. We could load it now. In fact, as you can see, there is something up here that we need. There is a lift further down. Is there anything inside that spaceship we need? Because that platform up there would not be there if we didn't need to get something from it. Okay? That sounds logical, right? Logical indeed, as there is now a bear up here. And as you can also tell, I'm using a lot of ammo here. And that will dictate to us that we need to do a lot of things. That this ammo is not going here. We can't go in here. We can't jump. There is nothing here for us. Nothing here for us. That's fine. I just wanted to cover the bases. Because there's a part of this level where I forget what I'm doing. And I did last time I played it. And it made me want to hurt myself at the idea that I'd forgotten something. Well, at least we know we don't. Ladies and gentlemen, let's press the button. Ah. What? Excuse me? 8th death of the series, but how the hell did that just happen? Was I right in the corner and the button press killed me? Are you kidding me? Oh, Jesus, what? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is a game that is 16 years old and that has just happened. Fine. Ugh. That has pissed me off to no end. Right. Has the satellite gone yet? Okay, it has, I think. Oh, that is... I'm sorry. I knew I was going to have a lot of bullshit deaths in this playthrough, but that takes the cake. That doesn't just take the cake, it takes the whole damn platter of sweet treats. I'm in a little shock here. I don't know what's just happened. Oh, great, those bears are back. Hello, dickwads. Oh, bloody hell. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'm sorry, I'm just so shocked with what just happened there. That was... That's never happened before. I have played this game for so long. I thought I would have seen everything. That is legitimately something I have never seen happen in this game. And wow, I am in a little shock. Okay, that's where we came in. So we know not to go this way. So by logic, we go through another door. And this is, well, another door. You late to the party, Mr. Polar Bear? There's two of them now. What the hell? I haven't beheaded anyone in this level yet. I feel like I'm missing a part of me. If you guys have watched the entire way through, I thank you up until this point. You've seen me headshot bears left, right, and center. There's a peacock, and that could have instigated another environmental death. Whoa, okay, that was bad. Seeker launcher. I didn't kill it. I didn't kill a peacock with its own weapon. Speaking of which, now, I bet you're wondering where we have to... Oh, bloody hell. You see what I mean, ladies and gentlemen? Because of the way we do this, a lot of our weapons' ammo gets used. And we don't do anything to really substitute it. This is what makes this game so challenging. Especially in its latter stages. Because the ammo pickups are fewer and further between. And this is what makes this tough. Are you fucking kidding me? More than... Oh my Jesus. That, ladies and gentlemen, was close. Now, as you can see now, we're loading up the booster rockets. Great. We're doing another thing. But as you can see, one of those hooks did not attach. Now, as you can see, quite nicely, is a target rockets. Okay, let's just shoot it. And as you can see there, those hooks are already up there in the sky. We can shoot this, and it lets the rocket off. And look at the physics on this. Look at the physics. Was there that much jet propulsion? But that is just convenient, isn't it not? Excuse me. Are you not going to take those anywhere? Was that button only meant to be pressed? Oh, another button. Oh, wow. I am so blind I didn't see the button. But there we are, ladies and gentlemen. The shuttle has now been fitted. Well, has it? Because I don't see the shuttle. Oh, it's on the fuel tank. Oh. Okay, my brain had a massive fart there that I completely forgot that wasn't for the shuttle itself. How stupid of me. I'm sorry, I'm still blown away by what happened earlier. I don't know what's just happened, ladies and gentlemen. But nonetheless, there's some pet yum down there, and we need it. As you can tell, we've been close to death a few times in today's episode, and I'm a little scared. I don't want to die in Cape Canado. I know it'll happen. Don't get me wrong. I am going to die here. In this level, but as you can tell, I'm going to switch to the plasma blaster here, because I don't want any more problems. We've got a few more doors, because this is where this level starts getting confusing, because... Hey, bears, Okay, there we go. I can blast them. It won't go very far. And that nearly resulted in another death. Automatic doors are not your friend. And as you can see here, there is the booster. And a metric ton of ammo. But we must... Oh, God. Stop the armadillo. This is... I mean, it may not seem that exciting for you guys watching at home, but for me, this is tense. Because I'm having to do this. I know I've played this game a lot. It's my favorite of all time. But I haven't played it knowing all the enemy layouts, where they are on the map. I haven't done that. I'm not the biggest nerd when it comes to my favorite game ever. If I did, this playthrough wouldn't be fun. You all know that to be true. This level would be, as with every level I've done in this game so far, very, 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 very plain, very boring. Because how am I going to feign my excitement or intensity at this? I don't know how you'd think I would, let alone actually do it. But this game is just, it's fun as hell, but my God, it is confusing at times. You don't know what to do or what to say to it, really. God, this, Cape Canado, it's stressing me out. I've gotten through this level by sheer luck. Sheer luck, ladies and gentlemen. And, really? Those bears came back to life? I need more ammo for my pistol, heavy machine gun. See, now this is the thing that I'm confused about here. The shuttle is ready for launch, according to me, right? But it's not allowing itself to be taken away. Now, is that for a specific reason? I guess it is. I'm going to hit this button again. With a pistol this time. Oh, here we go. We're ready. Okay, I'm guessing they just were waiting for everything else. Fine by me. The shuttle's ready. We prepped it earlier, but for some bizarre reason, it wasn't ready. Does the game actually want to cause me immense harm? Well, you just found a preview of it right there. And ladies and gentlemen, here we are. The shuttle's on the booster. I think it was just waiting for everything to be ready. And now, we are done for at least this section. Because ladies and gentlemen, we now have the undaunting task of trying to figure out what we do next. And that is a little frustrating, you see. Because where I've just been dictates where we have to go. And it is a little frustrating. I've just led you all on a wild goose chase. But this is the problem with the VAB building. It's linear, like other levels, but it's not so linear. It's surprisingly easy. There's so much going on in this level that you have to question what you're doing. Figure out where everything is and what order everything has to be done in. And you can see why I said this is one of the tougher levels. Because it's just so mind-bending. Just to remember which room you're in, what each room does, and just all of that. And as you can see here, the rocket's not been loaded yet because, ladies and gentlemen, this is at the end. This is where the exit is, ladies and gentlemen. This is where the level ends. It's weird, I know, but that's just what it is right now. And we have to get that rocket. We have to get that rocket. Armadillo. Sorry, sir. I'm not having you kill me later. You're dying now. God damn, I hate those bastards. Right. That's done. But where do we go from here is what you're probably questioning me about at this moment. What do we do now? Because we have two babies. The rocket is prepped. Or is it? Now, I say or is it like it's something that I already know. I know what happens next in this level, but it's just me figuring out my bearings. Because like I said, this is a confusing as fuck level. And it will mess you up at the worst possible time you could think of it happening. And, you could see... Look how confused I am, damn it! I'm looking for the door that I went through. This is confusing. This is, again, my point. Look at how confusing all this is, and tell me this isn't weird. I'm sorry now if I'm just a belligerent mess, because I don't know where I'm supposed to be going, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, would this be boring if I knew? Because even on my favorite game ever, I don't know everything, and it's proving it. Now, the rocket is there. There's a button here. We need to press it, because I think we know what's going to happen now. Here we are. The spaceship is now being taken away to its mover, its tank roller, whatever you want to call it. That shuttle is ready to move. But you must remember, we haven't done the one important thing. Get its mission instructions into the shuttle. We've not yet done it. So, ladies and gentlemen, we need to do that. And that's our next job. Our next job is to do that. And oh my days, you thought this level was close to being done. You are sadly mistaken. Because this level takes on a completely different life of its own now. I know we spent, what, roughly 40, 45 minutes just getting the shuttle together. You think that's going to take a while? Well, based on what we have now, it is going to take on an entirely different meaning. Sorry, you got to kill this peacock. Hey, it can't shoot us. We're fine. Let's move onwards. Into here. Into another part of this place. Oh, Jesus. Whoa. Oh, no. Ninth death. That's it. We're nearly on double figures for deaths. And if you couldn't tell, we're back here again. There aren't that many teleports. Again, I said about the weapons goes double for the teleports. Because they are few and far between too. This level is savage. It is throwing the difficulty level up to 11. And the bears are back. But the shuttle isn't. We don't have to worry about that. We don't have to worry about them, okay? We got our ammo back to near decent capacities. We have to now just avoid those enemies, because we don't have to worry about them now. They're not who we have to worry about and concern ourselves for. We know where we're going. We know what we're doing. And that's the important thing. Okay, peacocks deserve a special mention for death. But I now need to get away, because this is now a rush against time for me to get back into where we were before. And, oh, Jesus Christ! Okay, I'm going to have to think. Also, that's what a silver token looks like. Doesn't do anything for our token amount, but it at least helps us. Come on, send the rocket. I'm potentially losing even more health. There's another armadillo, are you fucking kidding me? Ah! There we go. This is, again, if you thought this game was going to be easy, look at what's happened here. I have potentially died 3 times because I can't switch guy. I could move myself to somewhere else, but I need tweak for what I'm doing. I need tweak for what I'm doing to advance in this level, okay? And you may think to yourself, Fred, why the hell don't you just switch character? I could if I wanted to, but I can't. And that's just how it is, ladies and gentlemen. This is out of my control. I forgot there were going to be 2 bears there. So here's a triple bomb for 1. There we go. Sorry, I had to pump that bear full of lead. This is why I've been so scared of the BAB building and Cape Canaveral's levels for years. Because it has led me to post-traumatic stress because of all this. And as you can see, here is an unauthorized ducks only thing. Hello, sir. Can I come through now? Only kitchen staff and deliveries pass this incident. Important stuff going in. Okay, now they have a person stopping us. Hello, depressed pelican duck, you bastard prick. I want to do something here. But we can't. Because now, one of the most laborious and most annoying, are you kidding me, is a polar bear and a crocodile. Oh, this is just brilliant. There's two of them? Are you kidding me? It's a peacock as well. Oh, you, that's it. That is it. I am going to say this to you all right now, okay? I'm gonna get back to where I was with full health, mind you, kill all those damn enemies, and I'll be right back. And I'm back, ladies and gentlemen. There was some pet yum down there, and I'd be aggrieved to not use it to reheal myself. Well, time to go back into the enemy jamboree that is this section. Fully healthed and everything. This level, ladies and gentlemen, it just... I have post-traumatic stress from doing this level in the past. It's just... it's infuriating how difficult it is. Now, I'm going to leave that crocodile here for a sec. Best I don't! Right. Sorry, crocodile. God damn it. I still didn't survive. Nearly. I am rubbish, ladies and gentlemen. And I've proven it once again. Now, here is more pet yum, thank God. Thank God there are no more enemies. Because I would struggle at this point. And oh no. Oh no, you gotta be kidding me. Not Sergeant Sternhouse, it's never since we got on long enough already. Ladies and gentlemen, as with Beaver Dam, I'm going to do this in my own time. So, whilst Sternhouse dances away, I will see you all in a bit once again. Jesus Christ almighty, this is going to get annoying. There we go, everyone. Jesus. I still hate those. Look at this. He's powerful enough to punch a damn vending machine. Fantastic. And ladies and gentlemen, look at all the thermal, but more importantly, look at what's inside with it. Another gun, the flame gun, which of course, by definition, sets its people on fire. Oh, yeah. Now, here is an important thing I want to alert you all to. Firstly, how powerful this gun is, but we will find that out in a minute. Because there's a bear in there, and I want to use this on that bear. Remember when I burnt that crocodile alive? Well, look at that. I burnt him completely to ashes without even really trying, and it's pretty bloody fantastic. Now, the question I have for you all is, what do you think we do next? Because there is a delivery, of course. There's also this. There's also that. We have picked up four weapons in this episode thus far. The freeze ray, the flame gun, the neutron gun, and the auto shotgun. Here's the fifth, the plasma beamer. And that is basically a smaller version of that. It is the plasma blaster, but in a longer continuous beam. Now, here is another chance where I have to go explain something. That there is a plasma gun. This here are the tables I danced on. They're tables that look like the configuration for the controller. Now, the thing is, all of these doors are metal. Or some of them are. They are reflective. The thing we have to do is to get a delivery to the people in there. That's what this wheeling tray is for, right? That's why I was looking at it when Tweet came in. There is a toaster. A toaster. I know, it's primitive stuff. It's ridiculous when you think about it. We have to put this down. A toaster is a broken element. You need to find another way to heat it. You can guess what we have to do, ladies and gentlemen. We have to make... excuse me. That's the freeze gun. No, I can't waste thermal at that. It's moronic, really. That toaster needs to be heated by the plasma radiation in that gun. And to tell you how testing that is, I can't even say. Do you know what we have to do? Move these so that the gun can move. And this is arguably one of the most frustrating things that this game offers. I told you that this game would be a pain in the ass. I told you it would have difficulty curves, difficulty spikes coming out of the ass. This, ladies and gentlemen, is what I was talking about. It makes its puzzles more difficult, its ridiculousness is out of this world, and just overall, why do I have to do this? That is the question I ask myself whenever I do this. And ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to waste your time with this. It's going to take me so long to do this. You'll wonder if I put the whole thing in uncut. What the hell are my priorities? I'm already losing viewers on my channel because, well, YouTube are dicks, and inevitably my content, as it's a multi-channel content channel thing, isn't for everyone. The fact is, I need to now get this done, and I don't want to make this episode, which is already probably going to be over an hour long at this point, go even longer than it already is. So you know what, ladies and gentlemen? I will see you all in a bit, and I am going to come back to you when this is done. Jesus Christ, it is going to kill me. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're back, and it's taken me a while, along with a potential scare in me nearly losing the footage I'd accumulated up until this point due to a corruption issue, but we are here, and as you can see, we just need to get this beam to that toaster, and there's a door here with a mirror on it. Let's hope to God this works. I've come back in here because I didn't want to miss the moment that this plasma energy beams that toast up. So, do that. Just come on. There we go. The toaster is now there. And that should equal toast. Excuse me, toast. Is there any toast here? Hello? Oh, there it is. That flew really far away from the toaster. There it is. Toast. We have a fresh, nutritious, or part of a fresh, nutritious breakfast. Here it goes on to the trolley. And lo and behold, we can push the trolley. And as you can tell, breakfast for the scientists, eh? We're going right in. Yes. Oh my god, that has taken longer than it should have. There we go. And finally a teleport. I said there was a Tweet baby behind that door. I was mistaken. There is a Juliet baby, if you could not hear the meowing. But we have to avoid potential death, because that is a rocket engine. And yeah, that thing could kill us instantly. Now, I've just wasted some time speaking to where I could have gone through, and that engine is now back on. There is a maze here. We have to get through this maze where the engines are not on, and then run through to save our kitten, okay? Sounds easy. Well, these things have different rates at which they shoot. So we could get through here, but that is gonna be really, really easy. This one, if you look at it, it's on and it's off. You see how quick that is? We have to be on point to make this work. And, oh, Jesus. Oh. Right. I know there are tokens down there. But you know me. I'm not 100%ing this damn level today. I've already spent too long trying to get this done. It's ridiculous. I don't care about a few tokens I've left behind. And I forgot there was more upstairs. Death number 10. We're into double figures. Looks like that 20 to 30 deaths figure I said confidently back before I entered New Quack all those episodes ago. Seems not likely. It seems likely that I'm gonna have to eat my bloody words and then some. That figure seems good. especially considering one level in particular we're going to get to later on. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're enjoying the fact that I am not an expert at the game that I know better than probably any other game outside of possibly Sonic Adventures 1 and 2. Okay? This is me proving that I really am shit at video games. Well, at least I'm not perfect. There are so many playthrough people or walkthrough people in this world of YouTube who are, safe to say, gods at the games they play. They know everything. What everything is, where everything is, and just, they know how to make a game slick and fun. Well, as you can tell, this game, this level, in fact, has taken me over an hour. I don't cut my playthroughs down, okay? Because that neuters the experience. I want to let you guys all know, hey, this is what happens in a game I like. It's pretty cool. And the fact is, thus far, I've proven that even the best at a game they love can fail at it miserably. And I'm happy that I've been able to show you guys that, because no other playthrough artist on YouTube is going to have this death to doing stuff ratio. No one. Because they don't consider themselves infallible. Or fallible. They don't consider themselves fallible, I should say. I consider myself totally fallible because I know it's possible. And I'm talking too much because I have to get through this. And, I don't like this section. See what I said before? Everything is trying to kill us. Because this is a level of near instant death sections. And I hate this. I hate this so much. Come on, just let me through so I can get my kitten. Oh, Pascal. How the hell were you not roasted here? I have no idea. But that's it. But you know what we have to do? Go back through it. Backwards. And I am partially shitting myself at the prospect of that. So you know what I'm going to do? I had to cause death 11. Because that puts me down here. Baby already captured. I don't have to worry about that. So that was a death I actually had to do on purpose. I do not feel proud of that, ladies and gentlemen. I don't feel proud. But it had to be done. God damn, that was... Oh, I hate this level. I hate it. Oh my God. Well, here we are with some foxes, my brother's favourite animal, but the fact is, let's hope that I don't cause them too much pain. Now, as you can tell, this is a giant... Oh, for God's sake. Foxes! There we go. This is a giant problem. We don't know what we're doing here yet, do we? Oh, Dillo! Oh God, I just want to get out of this level. I really don't care at this point. Just, whatever we have to do, this is the God Machine Valley of Cape Canado. It's long, it's winded, it's full of unnecessary bullshit. But at least I know there isn't a pattern in where the most difficult level in each hub world area lies, right? At least I don't have that to worry about. As Juliet is by God near death. And, oh, for God's sake, enemies. I hate them all. As you can tell. Also, I forgot to tell you guys this, because I'm not sure if you noticed. The weapon bar is full. We have every weapon in the game now. We don't have to worry about anything else regarding weaponry. We've discovered 5 weapons in one bloody level run, and we're fine. Chang, however, what are we doing with him? He's actually the smartest person here. He's an inventor, after all, so he probably feels at home here. Now, why am I leaving this section? To kill bears, obviously. But also for another reason, which will become apparent. Now, I went... God damn it, these bears. Sorry, Rufus, I'm having to steal some of your pet yum here. I'm going to need it. This, with one baby left. I've already told you it's at the end. I haven't specifically told you where, but... Ah, peacocks. I didn't show you how the plasma beam worked, did I? But I'll do it in conjunction with the freeze gun. It's frozen. There. See what I mean? It went down from whatever it was. See, if I press this again. 3 or 4 do each time. And here we are, out onto the balcony with the shuttle. Now, why am I out here right now? Because remember last time I went into the shuttle, I couldn't really do anything. In fact, it didn't allow me to do anything. It felt a bit out of place. Here, ladies and gentlemen, is where getting the mission instructions becomes our goal. As you can see, there's some crocodiles. Just gonna blast them with fire. I knew I wasn't gonna use this much. And there's some peacocks there too. And there we go. See, that will come in useful if you really don't want to mess with anything. Now, here is what I was hoping to do earlier, but because of this cockpit, I couldn't get in. That is a floppy disk. Unformatted, as you can tell by the statement on the screen there. That now has to be put with the mission instructions. What mission? You may be thinking. Well, I don't know. I don't know that much in-depth detail about the inner workings of a duck-run space conglomerate. Nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, we can't do anything with an unformatted floppy disk. So we have to go back. Lots of backtracking. I feel like I'm in a Metroid level at this rate. Probably am, but... I'm sorry, nearly threw up there. I would have thrown up massively and probably smashed everything in this little office of mine that I record stuff in and do other video-related materials. I would have raged immensely if I actually had lost the footage. See, the footage is already getting really long at that point, right? I didn't want to lose all that footage and have it take ages to render and stuff. So I created a separate file for this part from the plasma screen because I would have taken... I took 20 minutes plus, and that would have added an extra hour onto an already hour-long thing, and it would have just been too much. So, yeah, at least we've saved the video. But now, as you can see, there is a flap here. This is a computer sector with all the mission details on it. In we go, and... Really? The battery exploded. Up-to-date technology. And look at this guy. I didn't notice this guy before. Look at him. Vacuuming in the same spot. And look at those plugs. Look at those plugs. And as you can see, a place. Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to leap where no Firefox has leapt before. Now, I'm going to go back into this lift area and gain the last bit of pet yum that I can muster. Do you know why I'm doing that? Because we have to go inside that machine, if it wasn't made aware to you. Because of Quax's unbelievably horrible software issues and things that go wrong with the equipment, we are hired as part of our degree in astrophysics to sort out technical issues. Because people who work in this kind of thing know code. They know electronics. They know what they're doing. As for Chang, well, he's smart enough to know. He made his own bloody teleport system. We are inside, and look at that. No wonder it's so shoddy. Microchips, financed and put together by the Vigo Industries doctrine themselves. Doctrine? That's doctrine. Blah. As you can tell, look at how crazy this is. We're going inside a supercomputer, ladies and gentlemen, and it feels not as claustrophobic as you'd think. But then again, I'd have to question, how bloody big is this? How the hell do they just get people who are small in to do this? And no way. No way! We just got all the tokens! Ho ho ho! Just what I thought, getting all the tokens would be out of my reach. It's been done. Now we've got a crocodile to kill. Bye-bye, crocodile! Oh boy, all the tokens. We're going to do this 100%, aren't we? The run ended with Beaver Dam. And it's gone on. What the fuck? Hey. taking all that away from me. Also, there's a rat in here. I just killed it. And there we go. I killed a rat. Jesus Christ. And here is another one. Look at those things. Ugh. Sorry, sir. Melee attacks bequoath to you. But hey, hey. Get back here. Didn't kill it. There we go. Right. There's nothing up here. Nothing round here. Now it's our job to do municipal maintenance. And there we go. Machine's back on. Somehow, by pushing the battery over. I don't know how that's happened, but... Can I shoot this? No. See, it would be amazing if we could just get out of there. Then this game likes to torture us. Ow! I say as I bite my tongue. Ugh! Ah, see, this is what happens when most of my stuff is uncut, ladies and gentlemen. You get to hear me bite my own tongue. As we try to climb up this area here. Now, this is problematic, as you may tell, because look, we've got to get over this ledge. We can't. Lucky for us, there's a resistor out here. And there we go. That could have taken me ages, but luckily for me and my memory, I remembered that before it would do us any lasting damage. Now, why did I say that this game likes to hurt us? Well, at the top of this ladder, you're going to find out. Because, ladies and gentlemen, there is only one way off of here, and that is down. Now, I could drop off straight down either side. If you've never played this game before, you come out of there, that's what you think. Don't do this. Instead, go here, jump onto the stairwell. Stops your momentum, and it doesn't hurt you as bad. That is great. That is brilliant. And here is the formatted floppy disk, ladies and gentlemen, as the camera glitch, and we get a really big close-up of Chang's face. Brilliant. As ladies and gentlemen, our final mission is done. Our final mission is done. Because, ladies and gentlemen, we have the piece of equipment we so much require. And we can now put these mission controls inside the spaceship. And all shall be good. However, as you can see, we have a baby, but it isn't in the spaceship. You are going to make this mistake if you just go through with Chang with that disc. You need Rufus. And all will become clear in a minute. As the theme for him in Cape Canaveral is a military snare drum. I don't know if you guys could hear that. But that is the case. As ladies and gentlemen, it is time to put the mission controls instructions inside the spaceship. And we will then be done. The spaceship will be able to go. There we are. But now, we have to get off here. And that's a problem. Because we can't go backwards, can we? Because it's going to be a drop either way. Because if we went back to the area where Tweet came in, well, that's where the shuttle is now. Look at that. Look how majestic that is. Off we get. We hurt ourselves a little. But that's just how it is. And there we are. The spaceship is in place. And... I think we're done. We are. But there is an armadillo we need to kill first. Ah, you pricks. And here is the exit, ladies and gentlemen. The door opens. And you see, if you didn't know that there was a Rufus teleport down there, you wouldn't know this. Because inside here... is the baby we've been looking for, Bonnie. And we've saved her. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, the VAB building, the longest level I've done so far, is finished. 100% complete, and I did not think I'd make it. There is the exit. The spaceship is ready. We are ready. Oh my god, that has taken an age. And I apologize for the length of this video. But as you can see, an hour and 8 minutes I spent in this level. You've spent probably a little less time than that. But it probably has gone over an hour. I don't know at this point. But all I know is that this level, this absolute Satan of a level, is done. 100% in two, and I wasn't thinking that was technically possible. But it is. Oh, let's just head out of here. I've had a long, stressful day today with this, like, corruption, possibly, of my footage, which luckily did not happen. The software I'm using, almost failing on me. I bit my tongue. I threw up a little. I'm just on edge because this level wants to kill me. And ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, I'm immensely happy and I'm immensely relieved I no longer have to go through that hell. Because ladies and gentlemen, this level has always given me nightmares. I've had fears of going out of that level with nothing to show for it. And it shows you how much more difficult this game is. And it proves that this game has its levels over an hour long. It gives me time. I could have split this up into multiple parts of like 50, but then that would be pointless. As we go into Juliet, that sounds wrong. We save our progress and we look at this museum of discontinued and decommissioned space parts as we finish. I hope you've enjoyed this and had less stress of a time doing it as I have playing it. Because ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go next time back through those double doors. We are going to go to the next section of this level, this world of Cape Canaveral. And we, my God almighty, are going to set that spaceship on its next run to space. What will our adventure entail? Well, we don't know. As Juliet blows us a kiss, it's time for me to say goodbye for now. I have been Freddy Thomas. You've been people watching. This has been another part of the Fur Fighters playthrough for the CC Network. And I will see you all next time because I need to lie down. Ah! Oh.